Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to remove malware and viruses from your computer on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to remove any malware or viruses from your computer, I'm going to show you a few programs in this guide that you can run to scan your computer for viruses and give you peace of mind that you don't have any malicious software or programs installed or running on your computer. Now, although this guide is on how to remove malware and viruses from your computer, it also acts as a software service on your computer. And in total, I'm going to be showing you 5 different programs that you can use to not just remove viruses and malware from your computer, but to also make it faster and get it in a good working condition again. So the first program that we're going to be using is the Norton Power Eraser. Now, I'll also have a written guide, which will be linked in this video's description, and you can go ahead and get links to all of the software that I use in this video from my written guide. But the first program is Norton Power Eraser, and once you're on this webpage, you can just download it for either 32-bit or 64-bit version of Windows. Now, if you don't know what you have installed on your computer, you can right-click on your Start button, then you can click on System, and then here where it says System Type, you'll see if you have a 64-bit or a 32-bit operating system. But once you know what you have, just download the correct version for your version of Windows. Once it's finished downloading, just click on this npe.exe file. It's going to open the Norton Power Eraser on your computer. Just click on Agree. And then click on Run Now. And it's going to do a full system scan and scan your computer for any malware or viruses. Once it's finished, it'll show you if it found any threats on your computer. For me, there are no threats found, but if you have any threats on your computer, you'll see them in a list, and you can go ahead and select the checkboxes next to those items, and then just click on Remove, so it can remove those items with the Norton Power Eraser. In my case, I don't have any issues, so I'm just going to go ahead and click on Done, and then click on Exit to exit out of the Norton Power Eraser. Then the next tool we're going to be using is Malwarebytes ADW Cleaner, and you can find it from this webpage, which again I'll have linked in my written guide. You can just click on Free Download to download it. Once it's downloaded, just click on the .exe file to run it. Then once ADW Cleaner is open on your computer, you can just click on I Agree, and then next you can click on Scan Now, and it's going to do a scan on your computer. If it found any potential issues on your computer, it'll also display them in a list, and then you can click on Quarantine to remove them. In my case, there are no items detected on my system, so I'm just going to click on Run Basic Repair, and then click on Continue. It's going to close all of the processes on your computer, and then it's going to do the cleanup. And once it's finished, you're going to see this message that says your cleanup is complete. You can just close that, and then inside of ADW Cleaner, you'll see this button that says Try Malware Bytes Protection. You can go ahead and click on that, and then you can click on Download and Install. It's going to download Malware Bytes and install it on your computer. And then once it's finished, you're going to see that Malware Bytes Premium installation is complete, and then you can just exit out of ADW Cleaner, and you should have a Malware Bytes icon on your desktop. You can just double click on that to launch Malware Bytes. And then once it's opened, you can click on Scan, and it's going to do a scan on your computer. It's going to first check for updates, then it's going to scan the memory. It's going to scan your startup items, your registry, and the file system. And we just need to wait for all of this to finish, and then we can continue with the guide. Once it's finished, if it found any threats, once again, you'll see those items in a list. And you can just go ahead and click on Quarantine All, and it's going to remove it from your computer. You might even be prompted to restart, but in my case, it didn't find any threats on this computer, so I'll just click on Next, and then close this window, and then click on Done. Now, I recommend that you leave Malwarebytes installed on your system. It's not going to do real-time scans unless you have the premium version, so if you want to go ahead and buy it, you can buy it. But what I do is I just go to the settings by clicking on that icon there, then I go to the Security tab, I uncheck it from the Windows Startup, then I go to Account, and then I just click on Deactivate, and then click on Deactivate again, and it's going to convert the 14-day premium trial to the Malwarebytes free version. And then I always just use Malwarebytes to do a scan on my computer once every 2 weeks or once a month, depending on if I think there might be something on the system. But once you're done with Malwarebytes, you can just close it. And then the next program we're going to be using is Super Anti-Spyware, the free edition. And once you're on this webpage, you can just scroll down and then click on Download Free Edition. it's going to start the download. And then once it's finished, just click on the Super Anti Spyware EXE file to start the installation. Click on Next, then click on I Agree, and then just click on Next and Next again. And it's going to install Super Anti Spyware on your computer. Then just click on Next again, and then click on Finished. And then you can close your browser. It should open Super Anti Spyware automatically on your computer, but if it doesn't, you can just use the desktop icon to open it. You'll be prompted if you want to install an extension. You don't have to install the extension, you can just click on skip. It's going to open your browser, just close that, and it's going to open the Super Anti Spyware free edition on your computer. You can click on scan this computer, and then you can either do a complete scan or a quick scan. I recommend that you do a complete scan on your computer, so just select that and then just wait for this complete scan to finish on your computer. Okay, so once the scan is finished, you're going to see this screen, then you can just click on continue. It's going to show you all of the objects that it found. In my case, it's just some tracking cookies from the web browser, but you might have more results here. But to remove them, just make sure all of them are selected. Then you can click on continue. Then you can just click on yes. It's going to remove all of the items that it found, and then you can just click on continue, and then you can close Super Anti Spyware. Now, the last software that we're going to be using on this list is CCleaner. Now, I know there's a lot of people who don't like using CCleaner, but trust me, it works perfectly fine for what we're going to do, and it's not going to remove any viruses from your computer, but it will aid in speeding it up and making your computer faster. And once we're done using it, we're going to remove it from the computer the same way that we're going to remove all of the other programs, except for Malwarebytes, because that's going to stay installed on your system. But once you're on this webpage, you can just scroll down, you can click on free download, and then it's going to take you to a new page where it's going to start downloading CCleaner. You can just click on the CCleaner EXE file to launch it and start the installation. Next, just click on install. Then you can uncheck this checkbox to view the release notes. Then you can just click on run CCleaner. Once it's open, just click on continue. And when you're prompted with this optional offer to install the CCleaner browser or any other optional offer, just make sure that you uncheck any boxes and that you decline the optional offer, or else it's going to install some bloatware on your computer. Just click on Start CCleaner, and then on the left, click on Custom Clean. Then just click on Run Cleaner. Click on Don't Show This Message Again and click on Continue. If you get any additional prompts, just click on Don't Show This Message Again and click on Yes. And it's going to clean your browser and computer. And in my case, more than 1 gig of data has been removed. Once it's finished, you can click on Run Cleaner again. I always do this twice. And once that's finished, you can click on the Registry tab here on the left. Then click on Scan for Issues. And once it's done, click on Review Selected Issues. Click on Yes to make a backup of the registry. By default, it's going to make a backup of the registry in your documents folder. You can just click on save, then you can click on fix all selected issues, and then click on close. And then I also run this twice, so just click on scan for issues again. Then click on review selected issues, click on yes, click on save, and then fix all selected issues. Once that's done, you can close CCleaner, and now just do a search for the control panel. And then open the Control Panel app. Make sure that you set this View By setting to large icons. And then you want to find Programs and Features and click on that. Then make sure it's sorted by name. Then first select CCleaner, click on Uninstall or Change. Then click on Next, click on Uninstall. Click on Finish. Malwarebytes you can leave on your system, but you can also scroll down, then select Super Anti Spyware and then click on Uninstall. Click on OK. Then click on Yes. And then it's going to uninstall Super Anti Spyware from your computer. Now, obviously, you can leave these programs installed on your system. I just don't recommend that. I only use Malwarebytes in conjunction with Windows Defender. And that's the last program here. If you do a search for Windows Security, you're going to find the built-in Windows Security app. And lastly, you can just click on virus and threat protection. Then you can do a quick scan, or you can even click on scan options and then do a full scan. You can select full scan and then click on scan now. And then the Windows security app is going to do a full scan on your system. And Windows security in conjunction with malware bytes is more than enough to keep your computer virus and malware free. So what I would suggest is, if you think you have malware or a virus on your computer, then you can do everything that I did in this guide to get rid of it. But as maintenance, you can do periodic scans with malware bytes, like I showed you how to do in this video. And Windows security is a real-time scanner, meaning it'll scan your computer every now and then while you're using the computer. And if it finds any threats, it'll notify you in your notifications pane here. So basically, just let Windows security do its thing. And once every week or once every 2 weeks, you can open up malware bytes on your computer, and then you can do a scan with malware bytes. Now, once you've done all of this, I recommend that you restart your computer, and you can do that by right-clicking on the start button, then going to shut down or sign out, and then clicking on restart. But once you've done that, your computer should be virus and malware free. Now, obviously, you do get some threats that can't be removed by software, no matter how hard you try. And in that case, you will need to format your computer and completely reinstall Windows. And if that's the case for you, I'll link two playlists at the end of this video that'll show you how you can do a clean install of Windows 10 or Windows 11 so you can get your computer working again and that you can get it virus and malware free. But I hope this guide's been useful. And if you were able to use this guide to get rid of any viruses or malware on your computer, please leave a comment down below with your experience. Leave a like on the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.